section, we are going to see about how we can compute the expectation and variance of a binomial random variable and again apply those concepts to answer questions. Now, what is the expectation of a binomial random variable? Now, the expectation of a binomial random variable is equal to the number of successes. So, you know a binomial random variable x is equal to the way we have defined a binomial random variable. We have defined it as the number of successes in n independent trial where the probability of a success is p. So, now I can represent, we also said the binomial random variable arises as the sum of n independent. Again, I am emphasizing on independent and identically distributed Bernoulli trials. Okay. Now, I know that if x1, x2, xn are independent Bernoulli trials, it takes the value 1 with a success p and 1 minus p. That is what, because I say the probability of a success is with probability p. Expectation of each xi, again we have computed the expectation of each xi to be 1 into p, which is p. So, I have the expectation of each xi. So, expectation of x1 equals expectation of x2, which is equal to the expectation of xn. And I am expressing my binomial random variable as a sum of n independent Bernoulli random variables. So, once I have this, I have my x, which is expressed as the sum of n independent Bernoulli random variables, expectation of each xi equal to p. Again, from properties of expectation, remember expectation of x is equal to the expectation of x1 plus x2 plus xn, which is the expectation of sum is sum of expectations, x1 plus expectation of x2 plus expectation of xn. Each one of them is p. So, I add p n times to get the expectation of x equal to n times p. The key thing we have used here is to see the expectation of sum is sum of expectations. So, when I having the sum of expectation, I get expectation of x equal to np. Now, if I am looking at the variance of x, I again know variance of x is variance of x1 plus x2 plus xn. Now, I am going to use the property of variance, which says variance of sum equal to sum of variances if my x1, x2, xn are independent random variables. Recall this from our properties of variance. If I have n independent random variables, then variance of sum is the sum of variances. I use this, then I get that the variance of sum is variance of x1 plus variance of x2 plus variance of xn. Now, x1 is taking the value 1 and 0, xi takes the value 1 and 0 with probability p and 1 minus p. We have already seen that variance of xi is going to be p into 1 minus p, that is the variance of a Bernoulli random variable. So, variance of x1 is p into 1 minus p, variance of x2 is p into 1 minus p, this is also p into 1 minus p, giving the variance of x to be n times p into 1 minus p. So, I find the variance of x is n p into 1 minus p, expectation of x is n into p. So, the key result is, we use the fact that expectation of sum is the sum of expectation. We get expectation of x equal to np, and using the fact that the variance of sum of independent dependent random variables is equal to sum of variances, we get variance of x is np into 1 minus p. So, in summary, if I have x which is a binomial random variable with parameters n and p, the expectation of x is n into p and the variance of x is n into p into 1 minus p. Okay. Remember, I am using variance of x, I use variance of x or v of x, both of them represent the same. So, now let's look at a few examples and understand how to use this concept of expectation and variance. I'm tossing a coin 500 times. Again, each time I toss a coin, I know I have a Bernoulli trial. If it is a fair coin, then I have each of my times xi is a Bernoulli trial with parameter half. So, if I'm tossing a coin 500 times, my n is 500. So, if I'm counting the number of successes, then x is a binomial with parameter 500 and half. So, if I'm tossing a fair coin, then p equal to half 500 times. The question is, what is the standard deviation of the number of times a head appears? Again, if x is the number of times a head appears, I know x is a binomial with parameter 500 and half, half because I have a fair coin, n equal to 500, p equal to half, my expectation of x is 500 into half, which is 250. The way I can interpret this, if I keep tossing a coin 500 times, I can expect 250 of the outcomes to be head. The variance of x is going to be n into p into 1 minus p, which is 125. The standard deviation of x is going to be the square root of 125. So, I get the standard deviation of x is around 11.1803. So, now the other thing is, given the expectation and the value of n, can I find the probability? What does this mean? Again, if I know x is a binomial random variable with parameter n and p. So, I am not given n and p, but I am given expectation of x and I know n. Can I determine p? The answer is yes, because I know, if I know expectation of x, I know n into p, I know n, I can solve for p. So, given np and n, I have to find p. That's what it is telling me. So, again, the expected number of heads in a series of 10 tosses is 6. What is the probability that there are 8 heads? So, first step, x is a binomial. Again, I know it, the experiment is a binomial experiment because I'm tossing a fair coin 10 times. Am I tossing it 10 times? Is it fair? We do not know, but I am just trying to, I need to identify what is my p. So, it is not telling whether, it is just telling a coin. It is not specifying whether it's a fair coin. But I know n equal to 10. Let me keep p as it is. I am interested in knowing what is the probability that there are 8 heads where x is the number of heads or successes in 10 tosses. What else is given to us? The expected value of x is equal to 6. That's what we are given. I know if x is a binomial with parameter n and p, n into p is the expected value of x, which is given to be equal to 6. I have n equal to 10, so 10 into p equal to 6, which gives me p is 6 by 10. So, I get p is 0.6. So, I can identify the distribution of the number of heads as x is a binomial with parameter n equal to 10 and p equal to 1 by 6. I can identify my x as a binomial with parameter n and p equal to 6 by 10. Now, I want to know what is the probability that there are 8 heads. So, I am interested in knowing this. I can see that probability x equal to I know that the probability x equal to I is n choose I p to the I into 1 minus p n minus I, n equal to 10, I equal to 8. So, I get a 10 choose 8, 6 by 10 to the power of 8 into 4 by 10 to the power of 2, which you can verify is equal to 0.121. I leave this as an exercise to verify that 10 choose 8, 0.6 to the power of 8 into 0.4 to the power of 2 is 0.121. Okay. Now, sometimes we are given expectation and variance of a random variable. So, again, if I know x is a binomial with parameter n and p, the expectation of x is n into p, the variance of x is n into p into 1 minus p. So, given np and np into 1 minus p, so suppose I am given this is a and this is b, I can solve for p, which is very simple. I know that np equal to a. So, I know a into 1 minus p equal to b, which gives 1 minus p equal to b by a, or p equal to just 1 minus b by a. Okay. So, we can solve for p. Once I know p, I can solve for a, which is p, which is n equal to a by p. I know already this is 1 by b minus a. So, given the expectation and variance, I can solve for both p and n. I can solve for p and n. Now, if I am given p and n, I can find out what is the probability mass function of the binomial random variable. Now, let us look at an example. I know that x is a binomial random variable. N into p is given to be 4.5. np into 1 minus p is 0.45. This is the expected value. And this is my variance. So, from these two, I can obtain that 4.5 into 1 minus p is 0.45, which gives me 1 minus p is 0.45 divided by 4.5, which gives me that p equals to, which gives me, this is going to be 1 by 10, so p equal to 9 by 10. Okay. If p equals 9 by 10, I know 9, n into 9 by 10 is 45 by 10, which gives me n equal to 5. So, I have x is a binomial random variable with parameter n equal to 5 and p equal to 0.9. I can verify the expected value is 4.5, which is n into p. So, I can verify n into p is 4.5, which is what I have here. n into p into 1 minus p is 4.5 into 0.1, which is 0.45, which is what I have here. So, once I identify and solve for the unknowns n and p, I am interested in knowing what is probability x equal to 3. I know x is a binomial with parameter 5 and 0.9. Probability x equal to 3 is going to be 5 choose 3, 0.9 to the power of 3 into 0.1 to the power of 2, which I am going to get, and I can verify that is 0.0729. Similarly, I leave it as an exercise. Probability x is greater or equal to 4 is the same as probability x equal to 4 plus probability x equal to 5. Probability x equal to 4 is going to be 5 choose 4, 0.9 to the power of 4 into 0.1, and x equal to 5 is 5 choose 5, 0.9 to the power of 5, and we can verify that probability x greater or equal to 4 is 0.9185, which is the answer I get here. So, given the expectation and variance, I can obtain the probability distribution of my random variable. So, in summary, what we have learned here is what are expectation and variance of a binomial random variable. Remember, if x is a binomial random variable with parameter n and p, expectation of x is n into p, variance of x is n p into 1 minus p. So, given the expectation and n, we saw how to obtain p. Given expectation and variance, you can solve for both n and p and obtain the probability distribution. So, with this we complete the discussion on binomial distribution. So, the path we took was we looked at discrete random variables, and in the domain of discrete random variables, we focused on mainly certain applications which follow the binomial distribution. The next thing we are going to discuss is about continuous random variables.